मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर लेसन दैट इज फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ. ओके, इन अ प्रीवियस सेशन आई हैड एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द सेल ऑर्गेनेल एंड वी हैव टॉक मच अबाउट अ इम्पॉर्टेंट सेल ऑर्गेनेल दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम. ओके, विच आई सेड यू एज अ पीए ऑफ द सीईओ विच इज नियर टू द सीईओज ऑफिस. ओके, that I said you. Now we are going to talk about, in today's session we are going to talk about another important cell organelle, another important worker of the factory, that is cell, that is ribosome. Okay, ribosome, actually you are quite aware about it because in the previous session only I said you about the ribosome. Okay, student, here I will not write on the board, but I shall explain you and I will ask you in our PS period about the difference between it. See students, we have seen in the last session endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, two types of the endoplasmic reticulum we have seen. Okay, one is the rough endoplasmic reticulum and another was the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Because this is very important question, I may ask, or even in your final exam also the question may come, that is, what is the difference between the rough endoplasmic reticulum and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So I would like to know you the difference. You may note down because I am not going to write over here, you have to write it. Okay, so first point into the rough endoplasmic reticulum would be, it is most of the cisternes are present. Means rough endoplasmic reticulum is made up of what? Cisternae. If you have seen my last video, you will be able to know what is meant by cisternae. Cisternae is the fluid filled bags. Okay, fluid filled sacs. Okay, so this rough endoplasmic reticulum is made up of cisternae, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum is made up of what? Tubules and vesicles. Dear students, I said you this point whenever I said you the structure. Actually, rough endoplasmic or smooth endoplasmic reticulum, we can say, have a three main parts. That is what? Cisternae. Cisternae is what? Fluid filled bags. Okay, and rough endoplasmic reticulum is made up of the cisternae, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum is made up of what? Tubules and the vesicles. Okay, the second difference is that ribosomes are present into the rough endoplasmic reticulum. So only the name is given rough endoplasmic reticulum because these ribosomes are granular, spherical in shape, small, round, granular in shape, are present on the rough endoplasmic reticulum, which give it the rough appearance, and so that it is called as a rough endoplasmic reticulum. So ribosomes are present into the rough endoplasmic reticulum, while smooth endoplasmic reticulum ribosomes are absent, so it has a smooth appearance. Okay, I hope it is also clear for you. This is the second point. The third point is that it is also functioning an important role, that is what? Synthesizing protein. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is synthesizing what? Protein, which is needed for the cell. Okay, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum is what? Synthesizing lipids. Lipids are getting synthesized by the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, now where it is present into the human body? These are present, rough endoplasmic reticulum are present into the exocrine pancreatic cell. We have a pancreas, student. We will let you know in further classes. In your class 10, I shall let you know about everything. So pancreas is present, and there our rough endoplasmic reticulum is present. Okay, into the exocrine pancreatic cell. Okay, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum is present where? You can immediately say me, into the liver cell and the Leydig cell of the testes. What is meant by Leydig cell? That also you will learn in the next class. So Leydig cells of the testes and the liver cell, smooth endoplasmic reticulum is present. So I think I have given you 4 points and you will have to note down them in your notebook and you have to show me in today's PS period. Okay, now we will move ahead with our important cell organelle, that is what? Ribosome. We will go ahead with the ribosome. Okay, this ribosome is discovered. It is discovered by George Palladay. See the name, George Palladay, in 1953. Means before 50-60 years ago. It's recently discovered. This ribosome is discovered by the George Palladay in 1953. And it is composed of this ribosome. It is composed of what, student? It is composed of rRNA and protein. rRNA and what? Protein. Now, student, you may ask me, what is meant by rRNA? See, students, RNA actually are of three types. rRNA, mRNA and tRNA. RNA are evolved from DNA. DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. What is the difference? RNA we are getting from DNA. What is mean by DNA? DNA is what? Sorry. DNA is what? Deoxyribonucleic acid. RNA is what? Ribonucleic acid. Only the difference is of only sugar molecule. Oxygen molecule, sorry. One oxygen is less into the RNA, while one oxygen is more into the DNA. So it is deoxyribonucleic acid, and this is what? Ribonucleic acid. Only this is the difference between the DNA and RNA for your this grade. For this grade, you are learning in class 9. So for this grade, this difference is enough. That deoxyribonucleic acid means one oxygen is more and here one oxygen is less. And which is evolved, which we get from the DNA. Okay, RNA is of three types. rRNA. rRNA means what? Ribosomal RNA. Okay. mRNA means what? Messenger RNA. And tRNA is also the structure. These are all the types of the RNA. Here, there is no need to tell you all these things, but you should know what is meant by RNA. So, I will let you know. Ribonucleic acid, three types. rRNA, mRNA, and rRNA. And this ribosomes are made up of ribonucleus RNA. Okay, ribonucleic acid. These are made up of. So it is discovered by George Palladay, and it is composed of rRNA and the protein and the types of this RNA. Okay. Now, if we will talk about the structure of the RNA. Okay, the one thing. Where it is found? Occurrence. It is found in prokaryotes also and eukaryotes also. This is found in both. Prokaryotes, eukaryotes, no need to tell you. Pro means the lower organism, eu means higher organism. In the prokaryotes, but the location exactly of the ribosome into the prokaryotic cell is into the cytoplasm. Students, now no need to tell the cytoplasm means what. So, this in the prokaryotes, these ribosomes are arranged into the cytoplasm. Okay? And in the eukaryotes, these are found on the endoplasmic reticulum, that we say rough endoplasmic reticulum, as well as freely into the cytoplasm too. Do you get me? What I said? In the prokaryotes, it is found into the cytoplasm freely. Into the eukaryotes, it found in the form of rough endoplasmic reticulum, means on the rough endoplasmic reticulum, as well as freely into the cytoplasm. I hope this point is clear for you. Okay, so this is about the occurrence and what is exactly the location of it. Okay, now, if we will talk about the structure of it, how it is designed. Structure of the ribosome. So, structure of the ribosome is the, it is actually divided into two parts. This is divided into two parts. It has two parts. These are two parts. This upper part is dome-shaped. This is dome-shaped. Okay, this is dome-shaped and this is cap-shaped. Okay. This is called as what? Larger sub. So, this is upper part. larger subunit. It is called as what? Larger subunit. Okay, and this is of dome shape. This is of dome shape. And this is smaller subunit. This is what? Smaller subunit. And this is cap shaped, which is small. Okay, student. And here one thread like structure is present. That thread like structure is called as what? mRNA. Means what? Messenger RNA. Okay, that is called what? Messenger RNA. So, see students, this is the structure of the ribosome. Okay, if we will talk about RNA, then RNA is of three types, students. RRNA, then second is mRNA, and third is what? tRNA. RNA. This RNA is made from DNA. DNA is what? Deoxyribonucleic acid. Okay? Deoxyribonucleic acid. And RNA is what? Ribonucleic acid. Only the difference in between DNA and RNA is of only one oxygen. Deoxyribo. One oxygen is more in a DNA and one oxygen is less into one RNA. For this grade, it's okay for you to understand the difference between the DNA and the RNA. DNA means what? Deoxyribonucleic acid. RNA means what? Ribonucleic acid. So what happens here? This RNA is getting from the DNA. RNA is getting from the DNA, and RNA has three types. Ribosomal RNA. This is called as what? RRNA means what? Ribosomal ribonucleic acid. This mRNA means messenger ribonucleic acid. And this is the third type, that is called as a tRNA. Now function of this RNA is what? RRNA? To make a protein. To make a protein for the cell, for other cell organelles, and for other cells also. Whatever the protein is needed, wherever the protein is needed, that is provided by what? RRNA. What is the function of mRNA and tRNA? This m and tRNA also enhancing the process of the protein synthesis. They are also helping to form a protein synthesis. So I think this is for your grades, all right, to know you. So this is all about the RNA. Okay, now we will go ahead with our structure of the nucleus. See students, you were knowing I had explained you the structure of the nucleus, and in that I have said you inside the nucleus thread like material is present, and that thread like material is called as what? Chromatin. Okay, chromatin material. That material is called what? Chromatin material. That chromatin material is actually made up of DNA and histone protein. That is made up of what? DNA and histone protein. This chromatin material is made up of what? Deoxyribonucleic acid and histone protein. Whenever I explain you nucleus, that time I had said you. And inside it, one structure is present, and that is called as what? Nucleolus. That is called as what? Nucleolus. This structure is called as nucleolus, which is dense in nature. I said you, whenever I tell you nucleolus, here students, you should know, into the nucleus, one nucleolus also can be present and two nucleolus also can be present. It's not always necessary to have in every nucleus only one nucleolus. Sometimes two nucleolus are also okay. So nucleolus is actually the dense structure. It is spherical in nature, and it is made up of what? The structure is made up of RNA and protein. The structure is made up of what? RNA and protein. I said you that time. And what is the function of this nucleolus? The function of the nucleolus to make a ribosome. So nucleolus is called as what? The factory of the ribosome, because here the ribosomes are made. but it is not true completely. Why it is not true? I shall let you know very soon. It is synthesizing ribosome, it has been said, but not complete ribosome. The raw material to prepare the ribosome is prepared into the nucleolus. Nucleolus is made up of what? RNA and the protein. Okay, and the function of the nucleolus is to synthesize ribosome for the protein synthesis. But it is not true. Actually, the raw material from this factory, the raw material is only. Let you know very soon. Whatever the DNA material is present, that will be coming out through it. Okay, whenever it acquiring the shape of the chromosome, that time what happens, that we will see later into the cell cycle. But now we will see here, this is what? The nucleolus, which contains RNA and the protein. And I said you, this is the factory of the ribosome. But student, what happens exactly directly in nucleolus, it do not prepare. As I said you, the structure of the ribosome is upper larger subunit and the lower smaller subunit. Actually, this is not fused together. When this fuse together, when this both the structures are fusing together, it will be called as a ribosome. Until that, this is called as a larger subunit and the smaller subunit only. So, this nucleolus is actually making larger subunit and the smaller subunit. It is not making directly ribosome. Why it is not making directly ribosome? Because this larger subunit and the smaller subunit are coming into the nucleoplasm. This is nucleoplasm. Here they are coming. And after coming here, they are going out through the nuclear membrane, through the nuclear pore outside. Once they go outside, they are acquiring a shape of a ribosome. And after acquiring the shape of ribosome, either they are taking the place on the endoplasmic reticulum, which will be considered later as a rough endoplasmic reticulum, or they can suspended freely into the cytoplasm as a separate.